who are sons of men taken an evil time, when he comes suddenly upon them. And also told that all flesh is
as grass. They are like the shadow. They are like the flower of the field. Blows out in the morning, in the evening, it withers. But hello. As the scriptures tell us,
oh la la, oh la la, oh la la, oh la la, Papa ni oh la la, oh la la, oh la la, Anyi woro kuwe, Anyi woro kuwe, Nambilite no.
After the children of Israel, we shall take Isoko, Isoko orchestra. There is also the John orchestra of the Enkwa. And finally, the dancers of Sena Baja, fighting
So he's not the first who are alive. As Ezekiel himself stated, the living, even the living, they shall praise God. So the dead praise not the Lord, neither any that go down into silence. So the fathers to the children will continue to carry on with the work of God by his grace. So with these words of comfort, St. Paul now said, that if we Christians don't believe in resurrection, we are all men most miserable. Scriptures say, comfort ye, my people. What is the word of comfort? That is exhortation in regard to the resurrection of the dead by God's grace.
The Agbara community, please hold on. You will do a special presentation. When it is time, we shall indicate it to do.
Our late president was not afraid to die. As Shakespeare himself says, his covers who die many times before their death. The valiant never taste of death but once. Of all the wonders he said he had seen, it seemed to him more strange that men should fear death, saying that death, being a necessary end, will come from when it will come. And as the Bible tells us, there is no body who can hold back the spirit from the time of death. There's no discharge in the apostles. So when God says it is time to die, that person will die. But the important thing, as St. Paul tells us, is that when we are alive, we should live unto the Lord, do the work of God. So that when we will die unto the Lord. So that whether we are alive or dead, we are the Lord. And for this purpose, our Lord Jesus Christ died and rose, that he might be the Lord of both the dead and the living.
Offering. death itself came as a result of sin. And see how bad sin is. And since that time, the sentence of death was passed on man, people have continued to die. For the purpose of freeing us from the scourge of death, for the Lord Jesus Christ was sent. As St. Paul tells us in Hebrews 2, verse 9, the Lord Jesus Christ came to taste death for every man. And that sin entrained and partakers of flesh and blood. The Lord Jesus Christ himself took part of the same. That by dying and resurrecting, I save them who through all their lifetime have been subject to bondage, particularly through fear of death. We thank God and have His knowledge, His understanding. Pray God to also help us to serve God to the end by His grace.
Here lies the remains of our late president, Brother G. O. Ifasio. Motionless in that casket, about to be returned to the dust from where man was made. Genesis chapter 2 and 7, there it is stated that the Lord God formed man from the dust of the ground, breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living soul. The Bible clearly shows that death came into this world as a result of sin. When God Almighty created man a perfect human being, placed him in a beautiful garden, the Garden of Eden, and he provided all his needs for him. The all-wise God, who knows the end from the beginning, gave man laws with which to guide him. Out of all the trees in the garden, he is free to eat of them. But the tree of the knowledge of good and evil shall not eat of it. The day he will eat of it, he will surely die. But man was unable to keep the laws of God, so the sentence of death was passed on him. Genesis chapter 3 verse 19, it is stated there that in the sweat of thy face shalt thou eat bread until thou return unto the ground. For out of it was thou taken, for dust thou art, and unto dust shalt thou return. So from that time man began to die. But God Almighty, a merciful and a kind Father, seeing man in that condition, was not happy. So he made a way out by sending Jesus Christ into this world to shed his blood in order to redeem man from sin, reconcile man back to God Almighty. And by this, God Almighty manifested one of his attributes, the attributes of God. It's contained in John chapter 3, verse 16. And for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life.
The choir will continue their special presentation with the number Ogala Izuike and Igbo Ogala Izuike. Thank you, Brother Oriaku. Ogala Izuike.
Right. Of resurrection. God Almighty, through Hosea the prophet, stated that he's going to ransom man from the power of the grave. He will redeem him from death. And that will be on the day of resurrection, where all those who have gone to sleep the sleep of death will come back to life. And it is then they will be rewarded according to their works. Late president who is now sleeping the sleep of death, we see him again on the day of resurrection. Jesus Christ, our Lord and Master,
made this clear in John chapter 5, verses 28 and 29. That you should not be surprised at this. That a time is coming in which all that are in the graves, including our late president, who will soon be buried, they shall hear his voice and they shall come forth. It is then they will be rewarded according to their works. Those that have done good will be given a resurrection of life.
Yes, I see you now,
concentrating
on you.
Then you see a late present again in the grace of God. Now that he's dead, does not know anything. Solomon, Ecclesiastes chapter 9, verses 5, 6, and 10, there is stated that the living know that they shall die, but the dead know not anything. Neither appear any more a reward, but the memory of them is forgotten. Also their love, their hatred, all are now perished. Then in verse 10 is stated that whatever our hand finds to do, whatever good thing, it is now that we are living that we'll be able to do it. Because when one is dead, cannot praise God any longer. We see our late president again, the day of resurrection. He has finished his course, has gone to rest. He will remain in the grave until the day of resurrection. The coming of Jesus Christ into this world has really given us hope. Now that he's dead, it's not the end. We share in this hope before he died. If he dies serving God, he will come back to God on the day of resurrection by the grace of God. St. Paul, 1 Corinthians chapter 15, from verse 12, there is stated that Jesus Christ, when he came into this world, he died. He did not remain in the grave. God Almighty brought him back from the grave. And by that, he has given us, who are serving God, hope that when we die serving God, we come back again on the day of resurrection.
We shall be coming in the next 5 minutes while the choir will be taking a break. We shall call the Chidebere Orchestra to come out to perform. So please get ready in the next 5 minutes. The choir will be rounding off. Take a little break while we shall bring in the Chidebere Orchestra. We use two, we could do two events together so that we can eat up time.
Of life. Solomon tells us that human beings are like fishes caught in an evil net, like birds caught in a snare.
Chidebere Orchestra, please come out now. The choir is on break. We will not take Chidebere Orchestra. Then others which have been built to perform,